Hey everyone, Coops here from the whole box and dice. Well, this is very exciting. New intro, new graphics, the first Can We Flip It for Hour of Devastation season, and this whole season will be brought to you by the wonderful folks over at Good Games. If you are here in Australia and you haven't checked them out, please do so. They are an amazing team that love all things, not even just Magic, but all trading card games, board games, all the accessories you'll need to play it. If you're over in the States, they've got a store in Indianapolis, and they're just about to open one in Chicago as well, I believe. So super excited to see if we can do a bit better than Armonket. Going to be a tough ask. We went 5-2. For everyone who's watched this series before, 5 boosters. Thanks to Good Games, we're just looking for $20 worth of value from the set to consider this a flip and get a tick or a mark in the win column. And I think we're probably going to need every cent of that $20 because the value for Hour of Devastation is all over the shop. I thought I'd wait till after the first SCG, the first tournament, to see where the prices would go. Bolus dropped like $10. But we've had some stuff emerge, Fraying Sanity and Champion of Wits, Crested Sunmare is still holding some value. We've got 3 uncommons that are going to be worth more than $2. So that's Abrade, Supreme Will, and Claim to Fame. So there is definitely some value in the set, but there is a couple of mythics that aren't even worth $2. So look, plenty of time for that to change in the standard with the long rotation as we get into the uncommons. Got an Inferno Jet, Vizier of the True, and our first rare is going to be Chaos Maw. Oh, there's a foil behind it though. 4/6. Neheb. Yes, the Zombie Minotaur Warrior. Neheb the Eternal ZMW Mythic Foil to kick us off. That is incredible. That is going to be like at least $15. So that is going to be a-okay. All right, so this hopefully should be a pretty good start. We'll just open Mythic Foils for the rest of the packs, and that should be no issue after that. The Firebrand Archer. Really like Arrow Guide as well. Anything that gives evasion is super solid. Plenty of life gain in this set as well, I have noticed. Bit of ramp, a desert, one of the abominations. I really like the old school art on that Riverwinder. It's very cool. Angel of the God Pharaoh, Struggle to Survive, not the split we were looking for. Dream Stealer, ooh, and a foil behind it. Sadly, not a lot of value with Dream Stealer. Foil Mountain, oh, that's cool, it's the same one as behind as well. Foil Mountain's going to be worth a couple of bucks, so that's going to be okay for getting us to our value. Must be, that'll be fine. We'll almost be at $20 now, I reckon. We'll be probably a card or two away, but it's really interesting. You've got like Claim to Fame because of Death Shadow and applications in Modern seeing play. Abrade, obviously the fact that it's like Harness Lightning without the energy increase, and Destroy Target Artifact is so relevant. And then Supreme Will as well, which looks like that's going to be a pretty handy card for decks that just want to play a bit of control, but also if there's no use for it, you can get that card draw. So looks like a good card to hopefully pull in a foil. I'm sure they're worth a couple of bucks. Maybe like Sensor. I don't think they'll be quite Fatal Push value, but I think they'll be around that Sensor Harness Lightning value-wise. One of the Ruins. And Hour of Promise. Nice. Okay. Really want to see this card do really well. And I reckon that's probably going to do it, I think, with that, because that'll be a couple bucks for Hour of Promise. Plus, yeah, I reckon that's our 20. So if we've hit our mark, I will throw the flames up on screen. So hopefully we have flipped our first Hour of Devastation. Can we flip it? Tragic Lesson. I was interested by that card. I'm not really sure where it fits in, but it seems solid. Especially, obviously, with Kefnet, given that you want to have cards in hand to bring Kefnet online. Survivor's Encampment, Gift of Strength. I did one of that if like a mono blue control deck, if there's enough finishes with just Gear Hulk and Kefnet with, card draw like that. So we'll see. Torment of Scarabs, and the rare is going to be, oh, not a rare, a mythic, but sadly not one that's worth anything. Unesh, however you want to pronounce it. I actually was looking at the pricing. I think this is like firmly between Abrade and Supreme Will, so not even a couple of bucks. There are uncommons in the set worth more. There are 3 uncommons in the set worth more than that mythic. And it's just, like I said, it's a very, very funky value proposition right now for Hour of Devastation. Oh, I'm getting really good at knocking these cards up as I pull them out. The Naga, Wretched Camel. But, you know, there's a lot of time in Standard these days, which I am a huge fan of. And so there's plenty of time for these cards to bounce back. Obviously, any of these legendary creatures can have application in Commander, which is always good for their value. The Paincaster. Oh, I love Riddle Form. That's such a cool card. Consigned to Oblivion and Driven to Despair is going to be our last one. So, I think we're going to get there. I think that'll be just enough for 20. Last time I checked, our promise was almost $3. So with Neheb and the land, I reckon we will be okay. But gee, I think we just scraped by. Once again, huge shout out to Good Games for the hookup on these. I've got this new camera, but if I can't get the focus, it's like it's super screwy. Oh, there you go. It's back in focus now. Hopefully it's a good quality for you guys. You can see the cards easy, but just the focus doesn't seem to like cards very much. Two mythics, though. One foil in our first Cammy Flipper of the season, so can't be mad at that. But, oh, the Heb looks very good. Well, there's the Dream Sealer down there as well. Even if the foiling is a little bit dark on them, but that is, it's going to be a tick. It's going to be a tick. Mark a point in the win column. Let's see if we can beat Armon Ket. 5-2. Seems insane, but you never know. You never know. We might be out of flip 6 out of 7 or even 7 out of 7. So, Good Games. Thank you so much for the boosters. Just keep sending them with foil mythics in them, please, because we want to hit as many as possible. And look, I'm very excited to see, you know, where some of these card values even out at. We saw cards like Champion of Wits get a bit of value, played in Teema and maybe even the Blue-White Monument deck, which did a lot of work. But then you also have stuff like Mono Black Zombies, which everyone thought was done and dusted with Hour of Devastation being printed, the actual card, not the set. And that, I think, came like second or third in the Pro Tour, so, or in their CG Open. So there's plenty of cards that people are still trying to work out their value. There's going to be another couple of Champion Wits that are going to, you know, increase in value. I think the Eternalized cards have definitely a lot of value to them. You know, I saw a Pummeler deck do well, so, you know, maybe there's an RG Beats or Gods or Creatures list that can do some work. Blue-White Monument, I know there was lots of chatter about that online, so it'd be interesting to see how that sticks up, how that stacks up, and then, you know, especially with cards like a Braid acting as that dual functionality of, you know, popping a guy plus also, you know, also popping out or killing a monument or taking out an artifact. So I think we'll leave it there for today, but I'm keen to crank these out because I want to try and just get them done because I love cracking packs. it's like being addicted. So hopefully we can record another win next time. Thank you once again to Good Games. Please, if you haven't, like the video, subscribe, all the usual jazz. I've been Coops. This is the whole box and dice. Thank you so much for watching. We get to listen to the awesome wind sound effect and check my outro on the way out. Thank you again. Peace, guys.
You win!